America, the honorary member of the Lakota tribe, the proud Native American, set to do battle with Chavo Guerrero here tonight. And how are you so sure, Michael, that it's Chavo Guerrero was the one who influenced Vicky? Maybe it's the other way around. Maybe Vicky is the great puppet master that is pulling Chavo.
Well, you might be right. I didn't say I was convinced Chavo was behind it. I just said I had a feeling.
Or perhaps both of them worked in conjunction through all this.
Look at that image. Look at the image at ringside. Vicky Guerrero consulting with Chavo Guerrero at ringside in this business relationship that has developed.
Have you had a business manager?
No.
I've never needed one. Chavo does. You see, I do. Anyone who's successful needs a business manager. Hence the fact you don't need one. So you don't understand you're supposed to listen to your business manager. That's what Chavo Guerrero's doing.
The Taka Nice Arm Drag takedown of Chavo Guerrero as Chavo returned at SummerSlam, apparently for just that one night. And that's when the incident began between Vicky and Rey Mysterio. Chavo now out of retirement. First matchup back here on SmackDown.
And what has impressed me about Chavo, I grew up wrestling with his uncle Hector. Guerreros are just born to wrestle. Chavo Guerrero, several months off, showed no signs of rust at SummerSlam.
Tataka continues to work on that left arm of Chavo Guerrero. As the Chavo sucks chance, begin to fill the arena.
And how can these people have such disdain?
What do you mean, how can they have such disdain? Did you not see what Chavo and Vicky have done to Rey Mysterio? How they've broken the heart of that man? After everything that Rey has done for the Guerrero family over the years, and how much he's cared for Vicky and cared for Chavo through the troubled times of the past year, and then
how
they turn around and
cared?
Do this?
How much he's cared?
Yeah,
he was out running around as world champion while Chavo
shoulder
was
down,
the one
kick out at two.
Chavo was the one home with Vicky. And Rey was out gallivanting around, living his high life, riding in limousines, going to movie premieres, drinking champagne.
Rey did that.
Chavo was the one supporting Vicky.
That is just not true. I mean, Rey Mysterio did it in the spirit of Eddie Guerrero, number one. Number two, Rey Mysterio's got a family to feed as well. Rey Mysterio has a job to do. Rey Mysterio could not dwell on what happened. He had to move on in his life as well, just like Vicky said. And Rey moved on, and he won the championship.
Mysterio capitalized on the unfortunate demise of a person that was my very good friend, Eddie Guerrero.
How can you say that?
Because I knew Eddie. And he capitalized on it. Eddie's spirit doesn't need Rey going out there and saying, here's to Eddie Guerrero.
I knew Eddie, and I also know Rey, and that is not
what on it.
That is
it
not
made
what Rey
me
did.
Sick. It made me want to throw up.
That is not what Rey did. As Tatanka tries to battle out of this predicament with knees to the back.
While Chavo was doing what he does best, and that's take care of family.
You know what? You have your opinion, I'll have mine. I just find Chavo in face first goes Chavo. I find Chavo's actions and Vicky's actions as well reprehensible. As the elbow delivered to the jaw by Tataka. Chavo whipped across the ring.
Morals are relative, Mr. Machiavelli.
Morals are relative.
Morals are relative. Chavo took care of his family the way he knew how to take care of his family. Rey went out grandstanding. And how dare you judge Chavo, you jerk?
How dare you judge Rey? And look at the knockdown by Tataka.
How dare you judge Vicky? You're a jerk.
I'm not judging Vicky. I'm just explaining her actions, the inexplicable
go back to the match.
Tataka with that tomahawk chop across the head. Here's the cover and a kick out. Hard to even concentrate on this great match in the ring here.
It is a great match. Chavo's first match back since his retirement ended, and he takes on a great warrior like Tataka.
Chavo with those uppercuts to Tataka.
The man who's
Chavo in trouble. In trouble. And there is that Samoan drop. The end of trail is what Tataka calls it. Hook of the leg, shoulders down. Chavo manages to grab the bottom rope. That wouldn't have been good for business if Tataka had picked up the victory there.
But he didn't pick up the victory.
Well, look, Tataka thought it was a free count. Again, arguing with the referee, as has been a pattern over the past few weeks, as Chavo goes out to the apron.
Look at
now
this.
Now up to the top rope.
Look at this.
Tataka's in trouble.
Look at this.
Chavo Guerrero top rope.
This is on
coming to the
frog splash.
He's a Guerrero.
Eddie Guerrero's playbook is changed.
Chavo picks up the victory.
If anybody should do it, it should be Chavo. I've seen Hector do it.
Chavo.
I've seen Mondo do it. I have seen Chavo do it before. That is the Guerreros. Just like Corey Guerrero invented the camel clutch, Eddie Guerrero invented the frog splash. His nephew deserves to have the torch passed to him.
Chavo Guerrero using the frog splash to pick up the victory tonight in a successful debut of this new business conglomerate, so to speak, this partnership that has developed between Vicky Guerrero and Chavo Guerrero.
And Vicky Guerrero is loving it, as she should be. What a terrific partnership we have between Vicky and Chavo Guerrero.